If you want to create a Sling model for an AngularJS AM component, explore the component's behavior inside the page and maybe also fix an issue where your component is not updating when you edit it unless you refresh the page. In this series, you will learn how. Keep watching! Hi there! I'm Manuel Gutierrez from thelighthouse.co, and I make videos that help you learn about different programming topics like AM, Docker, TensorFlow, Unity, and more. So if you're new here, hit the subscribe and the bell notification buttons below so you don't miss a thing. Let's start! In the previous video, we saw how to create an AM component with AngularJS support, but we found one problem. Whenever we made a change, we had to refresh the page to see the changes. Let's see what's happening in the background. First, let's open the browser's developer tools by hitting F12 or function plus F12 keys on the Mac and go to Network. Then edit the component, make some changes, and save them. After that, we should see an error when calling the service to get the basic components data using model as the selector and JSON as the extension. Let's open that URL in a new tab. Also, if you want to check properties, values, and so on for our AngularJS component, let's install the Augury Angular plugin for Chrome or Firefox. Once that's done, go back to your page, click on the Page Information button, and then on View as Published. Opening the browser's developer tools should show a tab called Augury that will allow you to explore the Angular components. You can use the Inspect button on the left and click on the component that you want to explore, or you can drill down inside the component tree view until you find the basic components element. Here, you will be able to see the components properties and their respective values, like the ones for the checkbox and the text. We can even make some temporal changes here and see them reflected inside the HTML. Go to your IDE or editor and look for the model inside the core module. The model name is basic model and should be located inside the models package. We need to import the component exporter interface. Define a constant with the definition for the Sling resource type of the component. Define the getExportedType method to return the resource type. Also, implement the component exporter interface. Let's also import Sling HTTP servlet request and change the model's adaptables from resource to the Sling servlet request 1. Add component exporter to the adapters and set the resource type property. Finally, import exporter constants and the exporter annotation. For the exporter, set the name as Sling model exporter name and the extension as Sling model extension. Let's build and deploy the app again. Go to the page that was failing before and refresh it. We should be able to see our properties now. Go now to the page that you were editing before, edit the component again, make some changes, and click Save. The changes get reflected right away. Awesome! Congratulations and thanks for watching! You can join the free mini course associated with this video by clicking on the link in the description below. Share any comments or suggestions about the series or future topics. And if you like the video, also hit the like button below.